make a lot of comparisons about what this movie did right, or and what did the original movie did right or better. It's time for Mortal Kombat. Salutations, everyone. I'm Niru, and tonight I am reviewing the newest Mortal Kombat movie. Something I never thought I'd be saying, a rated R Mortal Kombat movie. Like, holy shit, we actually get one. But does it suffer a lot of the flaws of modern day cinema? It does. The movie has taken the turn of, well, cinematic universing itself, you know? And what I mean by it's doing its whole cinematic universe thing, like they make subtle visual references of characters that don't appear in the movie. They like talk about like, oh, here is like exposition about this legend, this tournament of fighters fighting together to protect Earthrealm so it doesn't be conquered by a man named Shao Kahn and everything. It has the flaws of the cinematic universe itis, basically, in typical things. But I feel like this movie doesn't try to like destroy its fun being that. I mean, the Mummy movie, that was already terrible, where it never focused on the titular character. It just focused on making it cinematic universe. Mortal Kombat gets a pass on that because, again, it's no one's story per se. But I can say, like, but then again, there's a ton of characters you could have made the main lead of this film and make it about them. The first Mortal Kombat movie, the original one, was focused more on Liu Kang and about him fulfilling the prophecy of being the chosen one. And in this movie, its biggest flaw, in my opinion, it focuses on a new character that is not in the games, not any game whatsoever, unless Ed Boon and the team in Mortal Kombat will make him a DLC character, probably, in the next new roster of characters they'll release for Mortal Kombat 11, which I hope they don't, because from the look of his powers and what he is like, he doesn't look like an interesting character or a fun character at all to play. At this point, Cole just looks weak. This new character, Cole Young, is weak. He is just absolutely useless. And I think he's just made to be the audience. Like, he is a character that is made, that is tailor-made to be audience members. Like, he's made for the audiences who don't know what Mortal Kombat is, who doesn't know the history, the lore, or ever has played the video games. Like, he is like the character that is made for people who are not well versed in Mortal Kombat knowledge. And that's all he is. He's just a pointless character. Like, he is basically tailor-made to be a supposed chosen one and not Liu Kang, who was the chosen one in the original movie. It's his story, basically, this Cole, but Cole is just uninteresting. Like, you don't know anything about him. He's an orphan, that's what you know. He has a family. He used to be a champion fighter, but now he just loses a fight. But even though he loses a fight, of course he's gonna make money out of it. You know, a Nacho Libre kind of situation, you know? And he is just there to just be the person that you dump exposition to and talk about Mortal Kombat, talk about the about Earth Realm and Outer World and shit, and that's it. You just dump exposition on him. He has no purpose whatsoever until, like, in a spoiler talk with Raiden, you find out he is a descendant of someone, and that's his role. Like, he's a descendant of this character in the movie that serves as a importance later on at the end. And the worst part about that is Cole, knowing that he is a descendant of this particular character, that makes Cole a plot device in this movie. Like, Cole is just nothing but a plot device. He's not a character. He's not even, he doesn't even have a personality on him. He's just bland. He's just hollow. He's nothing. You can replace him with any other interesting character in the Mortal Kombat games, and you wouldn't notice a fucking thing. Well, hell, if you removed him completely, I feel like the story could have gone differently, but better. And you could have introduced these characters in a different way that would have been more interesting and actually pretty good. But no, you just put it in this character, which leads to a problem in the movie that I'm going to talk about with the OG one. And that's with character development. All the character development of these characters of Mortal Kombat are not well developed. And there is like, and these are the two major flaws in both movies, and I'll get to why. So, in the original Mortal Kombat movie, we get to learn a lot about the characters in that movie. We know that Liu Kang is grieving over the death of his younger brother because his brother went to the Mortal Kombat tournament on his behalf because Liu Kang didn't fulfill his prophecy as the chosen one. And he does feel a bit of a regret to that, and he wants to get revenge on Shang Tsung for the death of his brother. And then once that happens, we get a cutaway to Sonya Blade, where we find out that she is hunting down Kano because she wants revenge also for Kano, for him, for Kano killing her partner that she was close to. And that was pretty interesting how we got development. Johnny Cage is ashamed and hating himself that everyone sees him as a fraud, thinking he doesn't know how to fight, and thinking that his fighting in the movies he does is fake, and he wants to prove himself. So he goes and gets an invitation to be in the tournament by his old master, which we reveal that his master was dead and Shang Tsung was posing as him. we get a lot of development from those characters. We find out why they want to go to the tournament, what purpose they had to go there. We learned a lot about them. We find out that they are after something, and it all takes place in Mortal Kombat. And it was well handled. It was short, sweet, to the point of showing what these characters are, who they are like, and what their personalities are, and what their goals are in the movie. Like, you start to see that. And they do get their arcs finished up pretty nice and tightly in a bow. Johnny Cage proves himself, Sonya Blade gets her revenge, and Liu Kang avenges the death of his brother and also fulfills the prophecy of being the chosen one. It is handled up nicely. We get to know a little about those characters, and it was nice. We get to learn a few things about them. It was pretty good. And the flaw about that movie that people always say is Scorpion and Sub-Zero's history has been nixed out of the film. Because, and for people who know the history, that Scorpion and Sub-Zero have a long battle of hatred with each other, between them, with the Shirai Ryu and the Lin Kuei. It feels so awful seeing that we didn't get to see Scorpion and Sub-Zero fight each other, which pretty much sucks that we never got to see them fight each other, which is sad because we should have seen that, but sadly we didn't. And I mean, we still get a cool fight scene between Scorpion and Johnny Cage and Sub-Zero and Liu Kang, but we really did want to see Scorpion and Sub-Zero fight each other. But sadly, we never got that. In the new Mortal Kombat movie, we do get that fight. Two times, actually, which is cool. Well, we get the origin, the backstory of Hanzo Hasashi, of how he lost his family, and how his hatred and rage start to burn through him for Bi-Han. And he wanted to get revenge on him, but he sadly got killed by the hand of Bi-Han in the past, and then lived in the nether realm for all his life to train and waiting to get revenge on Sub-Zero. And that was pretty good. We got backstory. Bi-Han hates Hanzo, freaking Hanzo hates Bi-Han. We got backstory, we got history with these two characters. We got everything about them. And here's the problem, just like with both the Mortal Kombat movies, both of these films barely show Sub-Zero and Scorpion. Now, Sub-Zero, yes, he's in the movie. He is in it a lot of the time, and he's working alongside with Shang Tsung. But even though he is working alongside with Shang Tsung, even though he is there, he's barely fighting in the movie. He's barely doing anything. We do get a fight scene with him and Jax, and he rips off Jax's arms as seen in the trailer. And all the action scenes you've seen in the trailer are basically all the action scenes Sub-Zero has in the movie. His fight with Scorpion at the end of the film, and every. I'll get to how he escapes from the Netherrealm, but his fight with Scorpion, which is pretty cool. I did like that fight, but it was an interesting fight because you knew the history about them. You knew about why they hate each other and why Scorpion is so hell-bent to kill Sub-Zero. You see it, and you know what happens. Scorpion gets his revenge, and Bi-Han becomes Noob Saibot. It's obvious about that. But sadly, they're not the main focus of the movie. Hey. It's like the creators of this film was like, well, they already did Scorpion's Revenge, the animated cartoon where it was focused on Scorpion and wanting his revenge on Sub-Zero. We already did that, so we can't fucking make it again. We can't make him the focus. We can't make Luke Kane the focus. We gotta do something different. What did they do different? Well, one, we're not doing a Mortal Kombat tournament. We're just showing Shang Tsung disobeying the rules and killing them before the next Mortal Kombat tournament even fucking begins. So, it is really like. So, in this movie, there is fighting, there is combat, but there's no tournament, which sucks. But, you know, it's whatever. Like, you still get the fighting, you still get the gory kills and the fatalities and shit. It's all there. They even say, test your might, flawless victory, and fatality, and finish him. They all say those lines, and it's so cool. It's stupid, yes, but hey, the original Mortal Kombat movie did that too, and it was awesome and stupid, but we enjoyed it. And I enjoyed it. The movie is great. It is what everything I wanted in a Mortal Kombat movie. The violence, the gore, the fights, it's all in there in this movie, and it satisfies me a lot. Kung Lao doing his like signature move of cutting someone in half with his fucking hat. Yeah, Liu Kang summoning his fire dragon and biting the shit out of someone and burning them alive. Oh my god, it's so cool. Seeing everyone doing their signature moves from the games is like the most awesome thing to see in this movie. Something that the original Mortal Kombat movie couldn't do due to limitations of budget and CGI. Like, they couldn't do that. And now, with this movie, with the technology we have now, sure, it's CGI. Sure, you can tell it's fake. But you don't care. You're seeing it on the big screen. You're seeing all these fatalities, these moves that you can do, and the combos that you did in the video games, all being played out to you in a big cinematic screen. And it is beautiful and awesome to look at. It is what any Mortal Kombat fan wanted in a Mortal Kombat movie. Gore, violence, fatalities. It's all there. Melina doing her teleporting move. I just saw. I was like, that is awesome. It was cool. I liked it. I loved the movie a lot. How fun and insane it was. I didn't care that, I didn't fucking care that, it was kind of stupid or anything like that. I honestly was having a fun time watching this film. And yes, the flaws are there. The flaws I pointed out about the character development with everyone else is not that great. Like, every character just appears out of nowhere and it's just terrible. Jax appears out of nowhere. Sonya appears out of nowhere. Kano appears out of nowhere. Kung Lao appears out of nowhere. Liu Kang appears out of nowhere. Raiden appears out of nowhere. Every character you knew from the games just appears out of nowhere. And probably the one, only the few characters that don't just appear randomly are the people from fucking Outworld. Like, they're already champions. And they're already freaking fighters working for Shang Tsung, and they have their reasons why they work for Shang Tsung. Like Melina, of course you know why she's there. Alright, and they explain it. Like, she works for him. Freaking Cabal and who else? Cabal, Melina, I don't remember the other guy. Oh, Goro's there too, but Goro is just there for one scene, and he gets taken out like a bitch by Cole. And trust me, that's the only fight that Cole wins in this entire movie. Half the other times, he's getting his ass saved by someone else, and that's just fucking lame. It's just annoying. But believe me, there are flaws that really irked me in this movie. And in order for me to go through these flaws, I have to talk about spoilers. I have to talk about what happens in this movie. So if you're not ready for that, go watch the movie. You won't regret it. You might like it, or you might not. Who knows? Okay, are you ready? Okay. So, the plot device that Cole is that he is a descendant of Hanzo Hasashi, meaning he's part of the Shirai Ryu bloodline. So, that's what Cole is. He's part of Hanzo Hasashi's bloodline. That's what his character is. But that still doesn't make him who he is because, again, as I said, Cole does not have a personality whatsoever. He has nothing standing out that is interesting about him. He gets his abilities, his powers, which is just this mechanical like suit that forms around his body that every time he gets hit, he gets stronger. So he's basically Dave Bautista in The Man with the Iron Fist. And he has these like hand blades under his like arms and he fucking uses them to attack his enemies. And he kills Goro so easily with this shit. And he got his abilities because, you know, his family was in danger, which is like a thing that happens. Kano gets his power of his laser beam from his anger. Or Jax gets his abilities with his mechanical arms, which was silly, but I liked it, by helping out his friend Sonya. Sonya, well, she just gets her abilities from killing Kano and she does her like little blast thing and kills Melina, which Cole said he could take on, but clearly he could not. So that's what. Goro's looking like a punk bitch now compared to Melina and Sub-Zero because Cole could not fight Sub-Zero. He was weak and he was trying to save his family from being cold and die dead from like frostbite, I guess, because Sub-Zero froze them just like how he froze the Hanzo's family also. And he fucking and the only way Cole could have beaten Sub-Zero is him summoning Scorpion himself from the Netherrealm with the blade that Hanzo used to try and kill Bi-Han, and he's that Lord Raiden gives him, by the way, and he uses it to summon Scorpion. Scorpion does his "get over here" and then pulls fucking Sub-Zero and then fights him, and it was so awesome. He even did his like fire. Like his skull, like fire breath attack on Sub-Zero, and it was so awesome. I fucking loved that. That was the coolest thing I've seen in this movie. Like, 'cause Scorpion's like, I can handle this. And Cole just didn't do jack shit. Cole just used Scorpion's like freaking like blade to stab Sub-Zero, but he didn't do jack shit after that. Again, that was Scorpion's fucking blade, not his hand arm swords that he has. Cole is just useless in this film. Like, it annoys me how useless. He's just there. He's just made for the audience for exposition reasons, and that's just terrible. He's like the white kid from fucking Forbidden Kingdom or the guy in Birth of the Dragon where he's just a white guy who's spectating the Bruce Lee and whatever the other guy's name is fight, and it was just so fucking bad. Bad. It's just bad. I'm telling you this, no one has any character development whatsoever. Sure, there's an exposition line here and there telling us their backstory of what happened to them and what's going on, but it's nothing. Like, it's just a line about who they are and why they do what they do, and that's it. It's told to pad out the runtime, have a little heart-to-heart moment, and that's it. Liu Kang has one, Sonya and Jax has one, and that's it. Not a lot of people has a lot of backstory. And the one character that probably is like funny in this movie that brings levity that makes me ignore all the flaws in this film is Kano. Kano is just a piece of shit. Like, this man is a total piece of shit. He is a total asshole in this fucking movie. And I fucking love him for that. 'Cause he is just an asshole. Like, straight up an asshole. Like, he has, like, no chill whatsoever. He is full on going Aussie on everyone. Like, he is a straight up Australian. Like, this dude just fucking hams up his performance. It's hilarious. It just reminds me of the guy from the original Mortal Kombat movie that goes, "Hello, baby, you miss me?" Like, this dude is full on Kano, and I love it. Like, this man has, like, he's like the audience that don't know much about Mortal Kombat. He's more like that, like saying, like, "Does everyone ignore me? Are we just gonna take this exposition or some shit?" Like, he's just the audience wondering, like, what the fuck is going on? Like they don't understand shit. Like, Cole is like the audience that are like, "Okay, I get it now." And Kano's like the audience thinking this is fucking stupid and ridiculous. Like, there's like parallels to this shit. And it is just damn hilarious. Like, Kano is just damn funny in this movie. Especially when he just like, "Kano wins. Yeah, fucking beauty." I love it. Like, he owns that performance in this film. It's sad that he died, but, like, man, I just loved him. He was such an asshole, but he was like a hilarious asshole that I just wanted to, like, laugh at everything he said, and I did. I just found myself breathing so hard and wheezing out of laughter, couldn't breathe. I almost missed a bunch of important shit in the process of his lines. But yeah, it's funny. But it is a movie with flaws. And Cole is like the main problem that makes those flaws. And that might be thinking that you're saying I'm being a bit too harsh, but honestly, I do feel that. I feel Cole is the reason why we don't get much backstory with the other characters that we know. We don't get backstory for Liu Kang. We don't get like any flashbacks or anything for all these characters. And I feel Cole weighs them down. Like in the original Mortal Kombat movie, again, as I said, they had all the exposition. They showed who to focus on, who were the main players, and why is it important to follow them. And you get to see their motivations, their reasons why they want to do something like this. I mean, sure, they in this movie, everyone shares a common goal. And that common goal is to find out what Mortal Kombat is and why they need to face this tournament and why they have to do that. Sonya is trying to figure it out, and Liu Kang was the one to tell them, which is good. I do like that they do this, but it's kind of terrible at its first half. And what I mean by the first half of this film, I mean, I feel like they cut it out a lot of scenes. This movie is 1 hour and 50 minutes, and I feel like this movie was 2 hours and 30 minutes longer than what this movie was released as. And I can see it because I feel like we were missing a scene. We were missing some dialogue. Like Cole said that Jax told him to meet Sonya Blade, and there's no scene whatsoever where Jax mentions Sonya Blade to him. There is a scene when they're being chased by Sub-Zero where he's like Blade. Like he only says Sonya's last name and that's it. Like he called her and saying like I got Cole and shit. But he doesn't say a precise location where she is or what's going on. Like nothing. Like Cole just randomly finds her and bada bing bada boom, there he is. Like it's just weird. And I don't get it. Like, there's so many things cut away. Even freaking Melina, she had nothing of an intro. They just show her, and that's it. Not only that, her face is just bloodied up. She doesn't have the sharp teeth on the side of her cheeks and mouth until, like, at the end of the movie. But that was the end of the movie, and it was one scene. She unhinges her jaw. She has all her sharp teeth there. We get to see it. It looks cool. And then Sonya just kills her after that when we saw her unhinge her jaw. What the fuck? It's just annoying that this movie just shows these characters, they disappear, and then die. It kind of just irks me a lot in this film that they have all this talent, all these characters, all this fighting, and then they don't have time to show exposition of character development or flashbacks or anything. And to me, I feel like Cole is the reason why it happened. Like, I feel like that's why it's weighed down a lot. Like, these characters are weighed down by a character that's only purpose is to forward the story, even though they don't need him. Like, these characters could totally handle themselves on their own and carry the film by themselves. Liu Kang could have been the chosen one that gives them the inspiration to say, no, we're gonna stand and fight our way, blah, 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 this. And they could have, but they didn't. It just had to fall into Cole. And he doesn't do jack shit at all. He wins one fight, but he has to rely on others to help him win fights. Like, I don't think he's a good chosen warrior. He sucks at it. Like, he really sucks at what he does. He's just a pointless character, and I don't like him for it. It's annoying. Like, it's annoying to see that. And it is the biggest flaws with this movie. Like, I feel like they cut it down important scenes. Like, Warner Brothers probably Batman v Superman this film, and we don't know it yet until we probably get an extended cut of this movie soon to be released on Blu-ray one of these days. And then they're gonna show like scenes that were cut from the film that make the film 2 hours long or whatever. Or they're just gonna show the deleted scenes on the special on the special features, on the extras. Like, that's all they're gonna do. I feel like there was more to this movie than what we were shown, because this movie is edited and chopped up so bad that it just feels like the movie has lack of losing something. And I feel like it's what kills the movie for me, but even though it does, it still doesn't ruin the fun experience of seeing these characters fight, seeing these cool worlds, seeing like the CGI, the impressive look, the beauty of this film. It was really good. Even the fight choreography and everything, they did a great job with it. And I'm not saying these people disrespected the characters. No, far from it. I say they paid a lot of good respect to the games. And any Mortal Kombat fan would agree to that this movie paid homage to those games and actually did it justice, did respect to it. Because they knew that the fans wanted a rated R Mortal Kombat movie, and they delivered. And I mean, sure, it's a jumbled up mess, but they delivered what they promised. And I'm not disappointed at all. I had a good time. The movie ended with a smile on my face, so I couldn't complain. Sure, I rolled my eyes a couple times, but I left the movie feeling satisfied. Hey, I got a rated R Mortal Kombat movie, something I thought would never happen in years. I thought I was only stuck with the PG-13 one, which I don't hate. That movie does respect and justice to the Mortal Kombat games as well. It just lacked the certain violence we wanted from it. But still, it did look like, I say it still looked like the games, like the OG games, which is actually the best thing to say about it. Mortal Kombat 1995 looked like the original games and does well by looking like the original games. Games. I think the 2021 version does well of portraying the modern day Mortal Kombat games. From the look of it to the feel of it, it feels like the modern day games, like something from 10 or 9 or 11, like those ones. And it does a great job doing that. So, is the movie perfect? Not really. But it was fun. I mean, the first movie wasn't that perfect, but hell, it did a better job developing the characters more. It's kind of like pick your poison, you know? You want a movie that does Scorpion and Sub-Zero justice? Or do you want a movie that does all the characters except Sub-Zero and Scorpion justice to, but also be reminiscent of the games? It's kind of like, you know, choose what you want. Like, choose your destiny and such. But this movie is far from a flawless victory. It got a fatality, but its execution was a perfect fatality, so I'm satisfied, if that makes any sense. Mortal Kombat 2021 gets a 5.8 out of 10. Could have been better. Could have been worse, but you know, it gets a 10 out of 10 for the gory kills. I'll see you guys in the next video. Ciao, darlings.
Ow, 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 ow.